Flutter is an open source mobile SDK developer can use to build native looking Android and iOS applications from the same code base. Flutter was officially launched in December 2018. Since then, the buzz around Flutter has been growing stronger. Spring Boot makes it easy to create standalone production grade Spring based applications that can just run. Spring Boot offers a fast way to build applications. So this is the reason why Spring Boot is one of the best frameworks that is used to build Java-based applications or microservices in today's world. Hi, my name is Pratap and welcome to PXP channel. In this series, we will build a simple Flutter CRUD UI and we will connect that to Spring Boot plus S2 backend. We will start with Spring Boot backend. And after completion of Spring Boot application, we will move ahead and build the Flutter UI. So I believe there are many ways to create a Spring Boot application. Start.spring.io, that is called Spring Initializer, is one of the best options to create a Spring Boot application. And we will create our application from Spring Initializer. We will now add the project metadata. We will name the group as com.pxp, artifact as employee database. We will separate employee database with a dash. Let's leave the name as it is and change the description to employee database. We will leave the packaging as jar and we will leave the Java version 11. We'll leave it as it as it is. Let's add the dependencies. First of all, we'll add Spring Web. Then we will add dev tools. We will need definitely a database. For this purpose, we will use in-memory S2 database. We will add that dependency here, S2. And last thing left to add is Spring Data JPA. We will add that dependency. That's pretty much it for this project. We'll go ahead and generate the project. Let's go ahead and click on generate. The project is generated and downloaded as a .zip file. We will unzip this file. Let's go to the location where the project is downloaded. This is the folder where the project is downloaded. We will unzip this. We will unzip to this location. Next thing we will do is we will import the project to Eclipse. I am using STS. You can use any IDE that is available in the market. You can use free to use anything of your choice. The project is now imported to SDS. Let me expand the main class. Yeah, as you can see that it's a Spring Boot application. We can directly go ahead and run the application. Let's see if it is starting. I'm clicking on Spring Boot app. So I ran it as a Spring Boot app and you can see that the server is started. You can see it says that Tomcat started on port 8080. That means everything is good so far. The project is running. Thank you for watching this video. We will complete the Spring Boot application, all the CRUD operations in the next tutorial. Thank you.